They didn't have a choice.
He wouldn't have come willingly.
He's gonna be, pardon the pun, fit to be tied.
He's coming too.
Who the hell are you? Hey.
Don't try to get up, Luke. Your son's duct taped you. You can't get up.
What the hell is this?
It's called an intervention.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You allowed this?
Everyone in this room is here because they love you.
Well, love me less.
And they are concerned about you.
Where am I?
One of my warehouses. I thought it would be fit for the occasion.
Did your no-necks bring me here?
You don't remember?
I was at Jake's talking to Siobhan. And you? Dodge. You were the decoy? And you knocked me out? I'm ashamed of both of you.
Do you acknowledge that you have a problem with alcohol?
Oh, jeez. I acknowledge that I was knocked out and brought here against my will. I acknowledge that I'm plenty pissed off about it, that I've got a jackhammer coming through my skull, so I'm in no mood to play your little game. Just cut me loose. Let's get out of here.
If I untape you, will you stay and hear us out?
And why would I do that? What's the matter with you people? What is this, safety in numbers? You couldn't confront me one-on-one?
Some of us have tried. All of us are concerned.
All of us? Does that include a perfect stranger? Who is this clown?
My name is Calvin Blaine. I'm an interventionist. Your family asked me to help.
Well, Calvin Blaine, they have wasted your time. I ain't gonna be interventioned. So you can take your tough love and your enlightenment and you can stuff it. And we can all go home.
All you have to do is listen.
You don't have much of a choice right now.
Are you proud of yourself?
As I said, everyone here loves you. Everyone here is concerned.
Yeah, I heard that. They're all concerned.
They want to express that love and concern and tell you how alcohol is affecting your relationships. So to that end, I've asked your family to put their feelings on paper in the form of a letter.
A letter.
Mm-hmm.
Great. So you've all lost your collective spine as well as your sanity. You can't just talk to me. You can't look me in the face and tell me what you have to say. You have to hide behind letters and this jerk. I tell you what, put it in a postcard and send it to me, general delivery, Morocco.
In order for this to work, each family member or friend needs to read their letter to you.
Yeah, well, this is what I'm trying to tell you, Calvin. It ain't gonna work. These people aren't here because of my drinking. Booze is just easier for them to wrap their heads around than the fact that I killed a child. Now, if you want to come at me about that, bring it on. You want to say something to me about that? Well, I'll take whatever you got. But don't do this excuse about drinking, because I am not an alcoholic. And no amount of collective concern is going to make me one.
Lulu will read her letter first.
Oh, I'm sorry, baby. This is so wrong. Your brothers and Tracy have manipulated you into this sideshow. I can tell you don't want to be here. And I know you're under a lot of pressure. Lucky's had a terrible loss, and you love him, and you want to support him. But this is not the way to do it. Your turn, cowboy. Let's just get it over with, shall we? I'm thirsty.
Dear Dad, I'm going to start off with a word you don't like very much. It's one that you railed against ever since I can remember. But it's one that you can't outrun. Hero. The day I was born, that's what you became. Whether you wanted to or not. You were my hero. And in some ways, you always will be. I learned so much from you, man. About loyalty and survival, how to think on my feet. You have no idea what it's like to have you as a father. You're the best dad any kid could ever ask for. That's why it's so hard to do this. To risk everything between us to make you angry at me. Or to make you feel judged. That's not what this is, Dad. I haven't lost faith in you. I can't. You know, one of the strongest memories I have of you is when we came back together after that first horrible rift between us. You remember that, don't you?
If I ticked you off, I didn't mean to.
What, ticked me off? You know, son, I never, ever considered myself father material. You know that. And that whole idea of role modeling, boy, that just terrifies me. Fatherhood to me was always a job that too many guys had who had no qualifications for it. I just didn't want to be another one of those guys, you know. I didn't want to perpetuate the misery and all the mistakes. But one thing leads to another. And there you were. And it wasn't a job. You were always good company. You let me do what I do. You do what you do. So if you tell me that I've had something to do with the development of a man who I hold in the highest regard, well, that's a blessing. I may be taller, but you are my hero. You are the role model in this family.
How much longer do you think you can keep that taller thing going?
Oh, leave me a little dignity, will you?
I'm in the unique position to understand exactly what you're going through right now. I know what it feels like to be where you are, to hear the things that have been spoken to you today. I know the rage that it brings. Walls start to close in. You feel like you're gonna suffocate. Because you know, with everything inside of you, that you're right. And everyone else in your life who loves you is wrong. I know what that feels like. I'm an addict. I went through it with pills and with booze. It doesn't matter. It's the same disease. And you have it, Dad. Are you hearing me? is one of the hardest things in the world to accept. And once you do, it isn't any easier getting back and finding a new way to live. I fight with it every single day. And I'm asking you to do the same thing. I'm asking you to fight the disease has you when you would rather drink alone in an empty casino than spend Christmas with your family. It's got you, man. Wake up, Dad. Are you really this blind? Okay, you know what? I'm gonna be selfish here. I'm gonna tell you what I need. Okay? My son just died. I need my father. I need you present. I need your wisdom and your clarity and your strength. Just like when I was a kid and we were underground and we were on the run and you'd come and you'd wake me up at 3 a.m. and you'd say, Lucky, we gotta go, it's time. They're after us, we have to move now. I don't want a faded, diminished version of you. I want you. I want my dad. I don't want to walk through this nightmare without that man. I don't want to walk through it without my father.
I would do anything for you. I would lay down across the tracks of an oncoming train, anything. But I will not lie to you. And I will not say something just because you need to hear it. I ran down your son, and I have to live with that fact. You have to live with the fact that I was not drunk. I am not an alcoholic. I do not have a disease. And I don't want to stay here another minute. Done here.